Good evening, I'm Alex Campbell and you're watching the second episode of Dissecting Track. On this episode, I'll be dissecting the second episode of the original series of Star Trek, Charlie X. This episode was made on a date and written by a person. Thank you. Now the basic plot for this episode is the Enterprise picks up a kid from this planet who has grown up all by himself after the rest of the survivors of a crash died. He basically turns out to be a massive asshole and has the powers of God, right? At which point the entire Enterprise is held captive by a moody teen who can manipulate matter into anything he wants. I'm serious, check it out, he turns his chicken to a lizard.
Charlie, what's wrong?
Crazy, eh? Before all of this occurs, Kirk does offer his chaperones who are transporting him up until this point to watch some pornographic material. Check it out.
We have a large supply of entertainment tapes, gentlemen.
Not really appropriate, Kirk, but the captain, man. Do whatever you want, I guess. So this kid has been completely isolated from reality. He's grown up and learned how to talk English from a computer that he was marooned with, and he really has had very minimal exposure to actual human beings up until this point. Check out his reaction to old What's-Her-Face.
Are you a girl?
Creepy!
Is that a girl?
That's a girl.
Creepy! And the creepy doesn't stop there, people. Nobody knows that this kid has god powers yet, but man oh man, should warning bells be ringing.
The other ship. They didn't like me. I tried. I'm trying to make people like me. I want them to like me.
Most 17-year-olds do.
I really have to go.
Can't you stay and talk a little more?
Look, I'm off duty at 1400. Why don't you join me in Recreation Room 6, Deck 3?
You got a deal, friend.
Ah, the 60s. Simpler times. And then Uhura sings a song.
Whose devil ears and devil eyes could rip your heart from you? We know not what you'll do.
Whoa, 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 kid. She wasn't that bad. Alright, maybe she was. So Kirk, who is a product of the free-thinking, sexed-up 60s movement, has to explain to this kid why slapping a chick on the ass isn't right, and he can just tell when the cogs are moving around in there, he just wants to say, nothing's wrong. Go for it, kid.
I see. Well, there are things you can do with a lady, Charlie, that you... well, there's no right way to hit a woman. I mean, man to man.
Seriously, this kid's a brat, eh? But obviously he's terrible.
Fucking sucker.
Captain Kirk from ship's galley.
Kirk here.
Sir, I put meatloaf in the ovens. There's turkeys in there now. Real turkeys.
That voiceover was actually done by Gene Roddenberry. I thought it was cool. Whatever the fuck he does. Also wanted to talk a bit about the picture quality of this version that I'm watching. Now for this version, they got the original negatives and they scanned them into a computer and they did what is called digital grading. And one of the main things that they did was just up the contrast, and I'll show you a frame here with the original negatives and the digital graded version, and it just looks so much more sharper and snappy and better.
What you do not know and must now be told is that my command orders on this subject are precise and inviolable. No act, no provocation will be considered sufficient reason to violate the zone.
This whole episode, I was just kind of looking at each frame going, oh wow, that looks really great. I wish the BBC had the money to do this with Doctor Who, but they don't, because they're poor! Sorry, BBC, but you're pretty poor.
Well, I did that to her.
Seriously, kid, this is getting really fucking creepy.
Well, I did that to her.
Charlie, there are a million things in this universe you can have, and there are a million things you can't have. It's no fun facing that, but that's the way things are.
Then what am I going to do?
Masturbate? In a lot of shows, I think one of the problems is the threat isn't real and there is no driving involvement in the narrative because there are no consequences and you're just kind of like, eh, who cares? I don't care about these people, I don't care about this situation. But this episode does a really good job at having all your main characters really like under the gun and the threat being really, really real and the consequences feel like they're drastic and permanent. You're like, holy shit, what's gonna happen? Then we all knew the show was leading to it. A borderline rape scene.
Don't ever lock your door on me again, Janice. I love you.
I'll lock it when I please. What is it you want, anyway?
You.
Gals, if a guy ever tells you you smell like a girl, just be warned. He's probably gonna try and rape you.
You smell like a girl. All the other girls on the ship, they look just like Tina. I love you.
You don't know what the word means.
Then show me.
Then show me.
No!
Also like how this episode explores the god complex too and what happens when someone has the powers of a god but is immature. It's cool to see a situation where it's a immature teen who's completely out of control with his emotions and his ability to connect with the world who has the powers of God rather than, you know, Hercules or something.
No. No laughing!
That is brutal, man. So of course we all know that the crew of the Enterprise foiled this kid's plan and the entire cast doesn't get completely obliterated in the second episode of this mass series. Now I'm not going to tell you how they foiled the kid's plan, but I do like the ending and I think you should watch this episode. It felt very fulfilling for me. I will show you this clip of him going away out of context, so it's not going to completely ruin the ending for you. I'm not telling you how they defeated him. Just letting you know, of course they defeated him. In conclusion, this was a great little episode. It really captivated me, and the threat was real, and the risk was there, and you had all of your characters doing their things, well established, good acting. The kid was an annoying brat, which was good, you know, the actor really conveyed that. You're really like, oh, this is an annoying brat, I really want to hit him. Maybe that's just the dad coming out of me. Anyway, thank you for watching, and it'd really help out if you could subscribe, like, and in the comments, tell me how I got all of the facts wrong and my opinion is null and void. Thank you, and good night.
I can't feel.
Not like you. They don't love.
I wanna stay, 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 stay.